Number two, their stubbornness. This breed is very stubborn, as I have found with Toto. He is a very stubborn dog, and if he does not want to do something, then he won't do it. I took him in a taxi one time, and the driver wanted him to sit on the floor. So I got him to sit on the floor, and he didn't want to. He just didn't want to when he was struggling with me. So I forced him to sit on the floor, and he wasn't very happy about it. He did not like it at all and kept giving me dirty looks. So they are very stubborn. Number three, cost. These are one of the most expensive dog breeds that you can find. I was very lucky, and I got Toto for £400. But usually they can go from 1800 to 1500. So usually they are a lot of money. So that is a downside to owning one. Number four, they are very strong. They are a very strong breed, and they can pull you along. I have asthma, so if my asthma is particularly bad that day, I have to give Toto short walks down the street, because he is very strong and pulls a lot. And the first time I walked him, it completely took my breath away, and I had to have my asthma medicine. I don't regret getting him, but if you want this breed of dog, that is something that you are going to have to consider. And if you have bad health problems that can't be managed, or maybe you're elderly and not very steady on your feet, then I would suggest not getting one of these dogs, but if you can manage one, then I would definitely recommend having one. Number five, not all bulldogs are the same. Toto is the first bulldog I have owned, so what I am going to say now is what I have learned from research. If you have owned a bulldog before and you really like the breed, maybe you want to get another one, just take into account that not all bulldogs are the same, and just because your first bulldog was a certain way or had a certain temperament does not mean that your second bulldog is going to be like that. They are all different and all have different personalities, just like people do. I have cats, and Toto for the most part is really good with them. When food is around, he does get a little bit snappy with them, and he will chase them from time to time. But when I tell him no, he will stop. He doesn't mean them any harm when he chases them. He just wants to play, so overall he is very good with cats. They can lay down together. When I take him for a walk, sometimes my cat Teo will accompany us. But not all bulldogs are like this. And not all bulldogs are going to get on with cats. So you have to take into account the temperament of the bulldog you are getting and the temperament of your cat if you already have one. Okay, so that is my video and the things that I like and dislike about owning an Old English Bulldog. I hope that you enjoyed this video and found it helpful and interesting in some way. If you would like me to make more videos like this, then please just post a comment letting me know, and I would be more than happy to make them for you. So that's my video and the five things I like and dislike about owning an Old English Bulldog. So please post sweet comments, like and subscribe. Do not dislike or post any mean comments, because that's not very nice at all. And if you can't say anything nice, then don't say anything at all. Goodbye, have a great day, and I will see you next time. Have a pawsome day, and I will see you next time. Goodbye. Have a pawsome day, I'll see you next time. Goodbye.